Video snapping, interactive synchronization of multiple videos. Here we have two takes filmed with camera pans that occur at different speeds. Trying to manually align the clips can be a difficult task to get exactly right. We propose video snapping, a method that allows clips to snap into temporal alignment when dragged by a user. Our method works by computing a cost matrix of frame correspondences shown on the right. A linear temporal mapping between two videos corresponds to a line in the cost matrix. When looking at the cost matrix, it is clear that this linear path does not match the camera motion fully. Our method also allows us to compute nonlinear temporal alignments such as this, where playback speed after warping is visualized in the timeline by the height of the clips. After snapping clips together, we can compute a high-quality spatiotemporal alignment using simple methods. Here we see a difference video after alignment and a composited result. Our method works as follows. First, we compute features from all frames in both images and perform matching between these features. Then we construct a cost matrix as a weighted histogram of these matches. Darker bins indicate a higher number of good matches. Using a graph-based approach, we compute temporal mappings as shortest paths in these histograms. Please see the paper for full details. In this example of a bike ride through a city, using a linear path, our method can easily snap between aligning either the beginning or the end of the sequence. The quality of alignment can be visualized in the timeline as the green and red bar above the clips. A nonlinear path allows us to match both the beginning and the end of the video. As our method finds an optimal alignment globally, we can recover from the missing region in the middle where the two routes taken by the bicycle separate. Our method is robust to differences in visual content. In this example, you can see that the car is not in the same place at any time. However, after snapping, the backgrounds in both sequences match. Despite the fact that the only features usable for synchronizing the car position occur in the small region above and through the windscreen, we can still find a clear path through the cost matrix. Here is another difficult example in which the visible appearance of both videos is very different. If desired, we can even reverse the direction of one video in parts. Here, two sets of actions are performed by different people that are temporally aligned. However, the woman on the left waves her arms three times, while the man only waves his twice. If allowed, our method automatically duplicates one of the waves of the man to best align the sequences. This is visibly indicated by the path reversing directions in the middle. Our method extends to multiple videos and can automatically find temporal relationships between a number of clips. Here we see five videos of a single event filmed on different devices and at different times. We can efficiently align these videos into a single global time frame as seen here. This allows us to create a single video of the event that cuts between all available cameras. High-quality spatiotemporal alignments are a fundamental part of many applications. In this case, we show an example making HDR video. Three camera pans, each at different speeds and exposure values, are used as input. Here we show the result of all three after spatiotemporal alignment. And this is the per-frame exposure fusion of all three videos. We compare our method to prior spatiotemporal alignment approaches. Here we can see difference images that show a similar quality of alignment. And here we see the images blended together. In this case, the slight differences in viewpoint are due to different video clips made available to the public. In this example, we compare difference images aligning two clips of a car driving through a road. Our method performs as well as or better than prior approaches while being the first to provide an interactive interface and without needing GPS data, complex optimization methods, or feature pruning. In this example, we see four videos blended together of a building with people walking in front. And this is the result after snapping and spatial alignment. You'll notice that some of the people are walking backwards. This is due to the different videos being recorded with different directions of motion. We can then remove the people from the scene by taking a simple per-pixel median after alignment. And finally, by carefully planning the speed of camera motion, we can achieve creative control over the temporal characteristics of two videos after compositing.